Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to another edition of MJ Every Day, a training-based episode for you guys today here at MJHQ with our in-house masseuse, Mr. Jake Watson.
What's going on?
What's happening, Jake?
Just working on the Vanilla Gorilla, man.
Making another guest appearance in another episode of MJ Every Day. Now, you are massaging Big Neve.
I am indeed.
Yeah, at the moment, looking very big.
I'm not sure Big quite cuts it with him at the moment.
Right now, and you massaged me earlier today.
I did.
And during our massages is when we usually have our D&Ms, and we were having a D&M about structuring training splits with particular focus on shoulders.
Yes.
So not structuring your training split that's going to put your shoulders in a vulnerable position where they're going to be vulnerable to injury.
Absolutely.
Correct?
Yeah,
so give us your thoughts.
All right. So pretty much like what we were discussing was the fact that young Joseph here tweaked his shoulder a little bit last week.
Correct.
And so we like broke it down on a few things, and then we looked at the actual order and structure of his training program.
Yes.
And we discovered he was training shoulders the day before doing chest.
Just to give a little bit of perspective, those of you who follow my workouts would know what my shoulder workouts look like, those of you who don't. So my shoulder workouts are very rear delt, middle delt, and trap dominant. I do I do no pressing at all, and I do very little that activates my front delts and shoulders. So my shoulders are pretty much rear delts, middle delts, and traps. And then the next day I go and train chest, and it's a pressing dominant chest workout.
So basically what we've noticed is Joe's shoulders wasn't handling it the best. And he's got reasonably healthy shoulders at the best of times, but he's a strong guy. And my kind of takeaway from it was that in training these isolated smaller shoulder movements the day before, he's fatiguing a lot of those small stabilizing muscles. So even while it's not particularly anterior dominant or pressing dominant, a lot of these muscles are still coming into play the next day. Because even though bodybuilders isolate muscles a lot, I think we can all agree that achieving true isolation doesn't really happen. Like everything's still going to contribute in the secondary exercises. So the argument of what we said was that if he's doing these big pressing movements on the secondary chest day, that it would make more sense to prioritize that onto the first day. So basically swapping his 2 days around and training chest on the initial day. And this is going to let him come in with the shoulders in a safer position because all those smaller stabilizing muscles won't be fatigued. It's theoretically going to let him move more weight on that chest day as well because he's not going to be having that little bit of fatigue through the shoulder, which is still contributing. And then due to the fact that he's looking at smaller isolated movements on that shoulder day, it's not going to suffer a negative impact from doing those bigger pressing movements the day before. So while you can have the split fundamentally looking the same, just swapping those 2 days around can have just massive changes to the health of the shoulder capsule.
And it really ties into, you know, I've done some episodes in the past of MJ Every Day. In fact, I did one in particular appearing on screen at the moment on direct versus indirect training. This is where it plays in. And, you know, I mentioned in that episode that whenever you train chest, you indirectly hit shoulders. So the ideal situation is to really not train chest and shoulders back to back, right?
100% would be ideal.
The ideal situation is to like train shoulders or chest, have 48 or 72 hours before you train the other one, shoulders or chest, because you directly and indirect hit them.
That shoulder capsule is very vulnerable.
But the way that my split pans out, it just so happens that I have to train them back to back. Just the way my split is, it either has to be shoulders followed by chest or chest followed by shoulders, in particular because I hit chest twice a week. So best case scenario, split chest and shoulders up by at least 48 hours.
Yeah,
72 is ideal. But if you're like me and you have to train them back to back, you're saying
I would prioritize
shoulders after
yep. Sticking to that principle of larger movements first.
Yeah.
So when we're looking at it like this, given the fact that those shoulder workouts are mostly isolation stuff, we're looking at getting those larger compound movements the day before,
yeah,
where the shoulder joint's going to be fresher, it's going to be less vulnerable with the stabilizers fatigued.
Yeah.
And it ties back into what we've said 100 times with this, but when you're looking at your training, prehab before rehab, when you're structuring your stuff, look at how to keep the joints healthy as well as keeping the muscles growing.
This same principle really applies to all muscle groups that are directly and indirectly hit.
Absolutely.
So you could apply this to, like, if you have to hit back and biceps back to back, you would say hit back first, hit biceps second.
Absolutely.
Hit the bigger compound type muscle group first, the other one second.
Your body's always going to fail to its weakest link. So yep. if you're fatiguing something small, thinking it's not going to have as much of an impact on a bigger muscle group,
yep.
that's where you're going to have the weak link in that chain.
Correct.
And all of a sudden you're putting a very small joint or a very small muscle
yep.
at the will of the amount of weight a larger muscle group's able to move. So if you're looking at fatiguing, like, you know, your tricep first and then going and doing a heavy bench press type movement,
yep.
these are all still able to move a ton of weight, and all of a sudden you've put this small elbow joint at the will of whatever that weight's going to do to it whilst it's fatigued.
I like that. That's very well articulated. Mm. Very eloquent of you there, Jake. I like it a lot. And another one that you just kind of touched on would be chest and triceps
Absolutely.
As well. So if you have to back up chest and triceps back to back, chest first, triceps second, and you can really apply it to every single muscle group that has a direct and then an indirect application when Absolutely. You're training them back to back.
Absolutely.
There you go.
Don't go burning your glutes out before you squat. Like, keep them warm, keep them active, but you don't want to come in with them super tired, because then all of a sudden you're putting your lower back at risk. It's like, you know, everything's got its place. Sometimes pre-fatigue can be awesome from bringing up weaker groups, but like we've said 100 times when it comes to this stuff, look at the prehab elements of your training and look at keeping yourself safe, because getting injured is the quickest thing to derail anyone in bodybuilding. So keep yourself healthy.
Fucking love it. And guys, that's a wrap for today's episode of MJ Every Day, talking about training splits and in particular, how to structure chest and shoulders back to back. As always, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, turn your post notifications on, both on your mobile, your cell phone, and your desktop PC, so you don't miss a beat when it comes to the Massive Joe's YouTube channel. Until tomorrow, I'm coming to you from MassiveJoes.com.
Peace.
Apparently everyone's gonna stay massive.
Thank you for tuning into this video. We hope you enjoyed watching. Don't forget to check out our latest upload and our recommended video, and be sure to subscribe to the Massive Joe's YouTube channel to stay up to date with all of our latest uploads.